er det Dan i Grenaa? Det ser du.
Oh, no, they suck it. Oh, they suck it. Oh, okay.
I'll see you on either side. You waiting for somebody else?
No.
Come, go place it down.
Are we doing that's the head?
Head facing me.
Head facing you.
Head facing
okay.
Me.
So y'all?
Pull out. On behalf of the Parikh family, thank you for your presence. On behalf of the Parikh family, thank you in advance for your presence here this evening. Jai Swaminarayan, Jai Shri Krishna, Jai Gurudev, Om. An emotional supercharge this afternoon, whilst we bid farewell to the gentle Mahendra Poparlal Parekh, we must also celebrate his life and remember this human being. An obliging child, a devoted spouse, a beloved father, a supportive sibling, a doting grandfather, and a sincere friend. Earlier this morning, MP, as I will call him, was asked to return home to his creator. In trying to be precise and simple, two marvelous characters that was of Mahendra Parekh, we must also allow ourselves not to be judgmental about him, but to gain comfort that he is now resting in peace. No pain or discomfort, just resting in peace. Here in front of us this afternoon, we say goodbye to a family member, a friend who often chose not to hug the limelight, but instead preferred being the doting and sincere person from behind the scenes. My duty this afternoon is to be a requested carrier of final wise words and communication by his adored sets of grandkids. I quote, "Our dear Dada, thank you for being the most incredible grandpa in the world. We will miss you dearly, and you will always remain in our hearts forever. With love, Jai Swaminarayan, Kaya and Pramukraj." Unquote. This following message has come through from Australia. "Our dear Dada, I miss you so, so much. We wish that you could come back. Akshi and I will miss playing snap with you. I'll also miss how you used to make up funny things about the birds in the trees. Whenever we hear a bird singing, we will always remember you. With lots of love, forever and always, Arya and Akshi from Sydney, New South Wales." Unquote. It's too many memories to talk about MP from Watsonia, Tongat, Seabells, Verulam, Parks, Cape Town. I think we'll leave that for another day. I'm going to call on the next speaker. And again, thank you in advance from the Parekh family for your attendance.
Swaminarayan Bhagwan Nijay Aksha Pushottam Maharaj Nijay Guru Hari Pramukh Swami Maharaj Nijay Pragat Guru Hari Mahant Swami Maharaj Nijay. On behalf of the Swaminarayan Sanstha of Durban, I stand at the podium today to pay tribute to an esteemed member of our community and a well-wisher of the Swaminarayan Sanstha, the late Param Bhagavadya Mahendra Bhai Parekh. It is true that we cannot appreciate joy until we are faced with sorrow. The height of sorrow is to bid a final farewell to a loving family member, a friend, a satsangi, or to a distinguished member of our community. Mahendra Bhai was all of the above, a key role player in the lives of everyone around him. His sad and untimely demise has left the Parekh family and everyone who knew him shocked and grief-stricken. It is easy to have faith in the logical and proven laws of science and mathematics, but it is very difficult to have faith in the unseen laws of God. Death is one of these unseen laws of God. Death is a sentence which none of us can escape. It is inevitable, yet unacceptable. It is undesirable, yet unavoidable. Despite this, with the strength and courage from the Lord, life of the living has to go on. Mayanbhai is truly a great loss, not only to his family, but to the greater Gujarati community. Like an ideal father, he was always humble and unassuming, and therefore dearly loved by all. His presence radiated warmth and friendliness, a kind of magic which attracted people. His jovial personality, friendly nature, and his happy-go-lucky outlook to life made him extremely popular. Above all, his daring and adventurous spirit was his greatest asset. Mayanbhai was also a very sporty and an athletic person from his young days. I can fondly recall many long hours that I spent with him on the golf course. The exciting golf adventures were always of joy to him. His passion for golf only waned when he was struck with illness. And he tackled his illness with great courage and bravery. I can safely say that the end of his worldly life is just the beginning of his spiritual journey to meet his master. At this stage, I join hands to Bhagwan Swaminarayan and to Pragat Guru Hari Mahan Swami Maharaj to grant Jyoti Ben, Ashirbad, and the entire Parak family the strength and courage to bear this heavy and irreplaceable loss. Yes, Mayanbhai will be sadly missed and will be fondly remembered by all. Happy memories will linger on for many years to come. May Bhagwan Swaminarayan lead the Parak family from sorrow to joy and from tears to laughter. It is only divine power and spiritual strength that can help us to survive and overcome troubled times. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Om Shri Sadguru. Mokshamulam Guru Kripa Mokshamulam Shivanandai Kripa Om Hari Om. The Atma is eternal. Only the body made up of the five material elements, earth, water, fire, air, and ether dies, and those elements return to the sources from which they have come. The Atma, in accordance with the karma of the individual, attains a new body. In the Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, verse 23, it very clearly emphasizes the eternal nature of the Atma, which is beyond the reach of material things. Nairam chintanti sastrani Nairam dhati pavaka Na chenyam pyadyantapo Na shoshayati maharuta. For this Atma cannot be cut by any weapon, nor can it be burnt by fire, nor wet by water or dried by the wind. People take note, we talk of the Atma and not the body. Death is simply a change of body for the soul, and the idea is aptly driven home by the reference to our everyday experience as given in the Bhagavad Gita. Vasam cheja nani yata vihaya na vani girnati naro parani Tata Shagirani Vihaya Jirnan Sanyati Navani Dehi. Just as a person casts off worn-out garments and puts on new ones, so as the embodied soul casts off worn-out bodies and enters into new ones. Bhagavan Deva Devasya Sargana Vasara Eshare Gora Samsare Sarva dukha mali vase Nana vidha sari rastaha Ananta jivarasya Jayante cha mrityane cha Tesha matto na vidyate Sada takatura Eva na sukhi vidyate kuchit Keno paye na mukshesha Mujyante vatame prabhu. Lord, the sustain of all beings in this world enveloped by darkness of suffering, beings in different bodily forms come and go. There seems to be no end. Show us the path by which man can be liberated and attain moksha. Chaturta lakshesu sarireshu shainam manushyam vityantra tadvana janam tu labhyate atra janam sahastranam Sahastara api kotivi kadachi lapte jantara manushyam punsanchayat. Among the 8,400,000 species of life on this planet, knowledge for liberation cannot be gained without being born in a human body. In no other kind of body can knowledge for liberation be gained. After countless births, transmigration, by merit of virtue accumulated, one may attain a human birth. Therefore, the human being should always perform good dharmic actions. Sri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Sri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Sri Jai Jai Ram.
all barriers, get yourself in readiness.
Thank you. Thank you.